I'm Don Rosendorf. I'm a member of Poets on the Fringe, which is a poetry workshop, and I'm going to be reading a few of my poems. The first one is called Air. I was going to write a poem today, but I did my laundry instead. The heft of wet underwear filled a void in the air as it was tossed in the dryer. A turnip on an empty white plate is not profound, but surrounding it with radishes gives it meaning. A soufflé must be prepared and served properly, or it will collapse upon itself, filling all the voids in the air. The wind is not seen but felt, just as the absence of you fills the air with emptiness. This next one is called Lucky Strike Hits the Bullseye. For people who are old enough to remember when it seemed as though just about everybody smoked. Lucky Strike Hits the Bullseye. So round, so firm, so fully packed, so easy on the draw. What were they talking about? A woman? No, it's a cigarette. There I am with a lucky strike pasted to my lower lip, and I had the routine down. Get it out, tamp it on the back of my hand, flip it, and watch it turn end over end into my mouth. Strike that match and cup it with my hand to keep the flame from the wind. Fire meets cigarette. And that first slow drag, nice and easy. Just like Bogey would have done it. Blow the smoke out of your nose and smoke rings out of your mouth. Watch the smoke rings move and go up, up, and disperse and disappear in the air, as flimsy as my half-forgotten dreams. This next one's called Nolo Contendere. Nolo Contendere is Latin, and it means I do not wish to contest. It's a plea in a criminal case that a defendant, that is somebody who's been charged with a crime, might want to enter. And basically what you're doing when you do that is you're saying, I acknowledge that the prosecution has enough evidence to convict me of the crime with which I've been charged. And I do not wish to contest. This is in place of a guilty plea. The judge will treat it as a guilty plea, but you have not specifically pled guilty. So that's nolo contendere. And there's one other phrase in here, a Latin phrase, nolli prosequi, which essentially means no prosecution. That's what the prosecutor writes on the jacket when the charge is being dismissed so that there will be no prosecution. Nolo contendere. Having been called before the bench, surrounded by marshals with badges and guns, I realized I was in custody. You are charged with 48 counts of not having lived, said the judge. How do you plead? I thought there would be a nolli prosequi, I said. The prosecutor, a tall fellow in a blue suit with a regimental tie, rose, looked down at me, and said, let's face it, there will be no nolli prosequi. How do you plead? The judge said again. Guilty, I said, but with an explanation. My father neglected me and spent all his time fingering vacuum tubes in the rectums of television sets. My mother had an affair with a used car salesman named Farbacker because she liked the way he jitterbugged. He was a ding-dong daddy who thought he could strut his stuff. What could you expect? The prosecutor stood up again and looked at me. He said, He hoarded filberts when the peanut growers went on strike and then sold them to his friends for twice what he paid for it. He bought his wife a vacuum cleaner for her birthday. His girlfriend said he was cold as yesterday's cucumber salad. "I find you guilty as charged," the judge said, "and I sentence you to the rest of your life." This last one is called Reverie, and it's set in Georgetown, back in those thrilling days of yesteryear when I was a kid. Funny how the shadow of a weed on the hot white pavement can take you to some other place, some other time. Walking down M Street in my five and dime sunglasses while Jack Playfair stands hands on hips in his Texaco station. "Hey, Hollywood," he calls. "Hey, Hollywood." Joe Bundy leans on the facade of the Nash Rambler dealership while the water in the horse trough on the corner of 29th and M shimmers in the sun. "You going sporting tonight, Speed?" He laughs his rich, dark laugh. "I will sing your song. The twilight music of ice cream bells and fireflies. The shake of the tambourine from the Salvation Army band at 29th and Olive. The men sit on their stoops in their undershirts, smoking, watching, quietly. Quietly, I will sing your song. All I have seen, I will never see again. Nothing remains but light falling on a red brick wall until the shadow of a weed on the hot white pavement makes it live again." As Bugs Bunny used to say, that's all, folks.